Welcome to the Big Bend. When people first come out here, they look at the harshness of the desert and think, how could anybody survive out here? But if you look closer at the plants and the diversity out here, you'd realize that everything we need is right here all around us. So let's go take a look at what we have out here and how we could survive off the land. This is creosote. This is probably one of the most common shrubs in the Chihuahuan Desert. It smells like the wood preservative you put on railroad ties and on telephone poles. It's also excellent for your stomach and all your internal organs, as long as you don't do too much of it. One of our rangers, whenever he had a stomach ache, his mother would feed him creosote tea. He'd rather go to school with a stomach ache than have to stay at home and drink his mother's creosote tea all day long. Here's one of my favorite cactus. This is the strawberry pitaya. Every spring, it's covered with purple magenta blooms. Then right after that, it starts putting on fruit. When the fruit is ripe, it's a race between javelinas and humans to see who's going to collect the most of it. This is the ocotilla. It's probably known as one of the icons of the Chihuahuan Desert. The ocotilla will bloom in the springtime, and you can take those flowers and make a tea out of it. It tastes a lot like hibiscus flower tea. A lot of the corrals out here are made out of ocotilla stalks. Don't even have to use your barbed wire. It carries its own barbs on it. Sotol is probably one of the most versatile plants in all the Chihuahuan Desert. Just about everything on this plant can be used. You have these wonderful green straps. You can weave them together for floor mats or bedding mats, as cordage for anything you might need to tie together. These will work. Then what you're left with is the heart of the sotol. It's the heart of the sotol we can eat. You dig a pit, line the pit with rock, build a fire inside the pit, let it burn down the coals. Throw the sotol heart on top of these coals. The next morning, you take your machete and you split it open in the middle. And then you take the tender leaves that are on the inside and you scrape the meat off between your teeth like you would be eating an artichoke. And be surprised how sweet it is. It tastes a lot like a cabbage that's been cooked in brown sugar. The desert seems to be a harsh environment, but as you can tell, the desert is full of life. So come visit us here at Big Bend Ranch State Park. Yeehaw!